Okay, sound. I'm glad to hear you talk back to me. So we're already interacting. That's fantastic. I love to come to something that's called Creative Fridays, because I think about being creative every single day. My life is based on creating things, and you know, a lot of times it's harder than you think. And we live in a world where people have demands and deadlines and, you know, they expect things right away. And people say, well, you know, when are you going to get this done? And I go, I don't know. No one's ever created this before. And it's going to take some time. You know, we have to try things. So that's the frustrating thing. You know, sometimes I go, what do you think of this idea? And they go, well, it's interesting. Why don't you develop it a little longer? Tell me how we've gotten with it in about 30 years, you know. I mean, creativity is a struggle. And, you know, but the reward is that we can create things that have lasting value. You can have an idea that's, you're the first person that created that idea that could last basically for the rest of the history of mankind. You could produce an image or write something, you know, that'll last as long as civilization does. And the satisfaction, even though it's a struggle, and sometimes we don't get the monetary rewards and the things right away, that it's worth it, because in the long term, you can have the satisfaction that you can make a true difference that lasts, you know, for generations even. So I am interested in how the brain works. And I'd like to know how the brain works in order to be able to use that knowledge in order to treat blindness, to give vision back to blind people. And, you know, if you're going to try to do something like that, you have to start somewhere. And kind of like with a test bed of some sort. And I'm so thrilled to be here at something called Color, because I love color. I think of 16 hours a day, I'm thinking about color. And it turns out that about one out of every 12 men in the United States has some form of red-green color blindness. So it's the most common genetic disorder in people. And these people, you know, they're color blind. So they have a form of loss of vision. And there are monkeys that are like people, in that there are some individuals in the population that have normal color vision, but other males, like this guy right here, that's his name is Sam, was born with red-green color blindness. And we've developed a method of curing color blindness. We've been able to cure color blindness in Sam. And but in order to really kind of, this opens a whole idea basically about how our vision works and how our brain works, and gives us things that wouldn't be possible to think about, you know, before we were able to do this kind of thing. Well, as a scientist, one of the things that we need to be able to do is we have to understand the relationship between the